Do you find the way OBS looks a little boring? Want to spice it up? I've covered a gamut of plugins and features for OBS Studio, but we haven't talked about customizing its appearance much yet. Today, let's cover five, well, actually it's closer to nine custom themes for OBS Studio in today's video. I'm EposVox, the Stream Professor, and OBS Studio has supported custom theming for a little while now. I haven't talked about it much, but it has. But there's a criminal lack of custom themes being made for it. Let you in on a little secret? That's part of my motivation for making this video. Yes, I want to feature cool themes that already exist, but I want more people getting their hands dirty, improving OBS's UI and appearance, so I'm raising awareness or something. Let's jump in with theme number one, Ocean Blue. This is a theme created by Zamar, the developer of the StreamFX plugin. Ocean Blue takes OBS's UI and gives you a darker theme with a splash of color. Pun intended. A brighter blue is used for the window bar, a less bright color for buttons and dropdowns, and then a darker shade for the background. This is similar to the dark theme, but with a little more contrast and visibility. Instead of a slight color variance to indicate when buttons like Studio Mode are pressed, a check mark is actually placed as an indicator, which is a fair bit more clear and obvious when you're just looking at it at a glance. While we're customizing how OBS looks, would you like to improve how your stream sounds without worrying about DMCA issues? Check out Backing Track, royalty-free rock and metal music that's safe to use in your streams, videos, podcasts, and free to download and remix for yourself. And we have stems available. Playlists on various streaming services are available at backingtrack.gg. Free downloads, including the stems and even flat copies with album art, available on our Discord server at discord.gg/EposVox. We're also on Pretzel Rocks, so wherever you are, give it a listen today. Next up, we have a pair of themes hoping to improve the dark theme idea. Flat Dark Theme takes the dark theme and fits it more in line with the flat UI design you'd see on some Linux distro themes and the like. I find the grays a bit more pleasing here, but I'm not a fan of flat UI design overall myself, but I know a lot of people like this kind of thing. On the other hand, High-DPI eye-friendly dark theme mostly keeps the normal dark theme just left alone, aside from a bigger font that makes it easier on the eyes for high-resolution screens with higher scaling factors. As a 4K monitor user, this is a sight for sore eyes. Ba-doom-tsh. The next theme is Loud, although it doesn't make any noise. This is the CGC theme. It actually comes from a site dedicated to resources for camgirls called Camgirl Cloud. So if you want resources on that, there you go. Regardless of the source, you get bright pinks, purples, and in-betweens that fit my branding a little bit and might be what you're looking for. If all these themes so far are a little too dark and moody, a user by the name of Prequi has made a light theme. Like an actual light theme, not the system default theme. This one is actually impressive, and for those of you not obsessed with dark mode everything, it seems like a nice upgrade to over the older system theme that used to be default, but is still included with OBS. Lastly, we have a group of four themes designed to emulate the look of other platforms or programs. First, we have the StreamLabs theme by Kevin ECTV, which uses the Ratchney theme as a base and the Nodo Sans font to make OBS Studio look a little bit more like StreamLabs OBS. This is great for users who just like the color scheme or are perhaps migrating from StreamLabs OBS over to OBS Studio and just want ever so slightly a little bit more familiarity. Then we have three themes by Dare Meeps based on different streaming platforms. Twitchy for Twitch, YouTubey for YouTube, and Mixery for the dearly, dearly missed Mixer. These add very pleasing color accents and a nice overall presentation to OBS Studio, especially when used with the Comforta regular fonts. Twitchy has been my favorite theme for a long time, and I've been using it in videos off and on for a few years now. I know this might seem like a silly thing to make a video on, but not enough people know that OBS themes are even a thing or how to customize it, and I want to get more people talking about it and making more themes. I'll have a short going live today as well showing you how to install these themes if you need the extra help. Hit the like button if you enjoyed, get subscribed, and check out Backing Track linked below. Thanks for watching, and remember, be kind, rewind.